We're joined now by Dr. Kris Hiney, our extension equine specialist. Kris, we want to talk a little bit about blister beetles, a good topic to cover this time of year, and just kind of remind people to be aware and some of the things they need to look out for, right?
Yeah, so sometimes in the fall, you can actually have swarms of blister beetles that may actually invade your property, and they may even like come into your barn looking to get out of the heat and the sun. So certainly if you see a lot of insect activity in beetles, particularly striped blister beetles, you want to make sure you address that right away. There are pesticides that you can apply, essentially premise sprays that can go onto the surfaces of the building. Those don't go on the animals, of course. We use different products for pest control on an animal versus off. But if there's dead beetles anywhere after that, you got to make sure you get rid of all of those, because even a few of them, if the horse accidentally ingests some, can be lethal. And then the more common way they usually get them is actually through hay. So I always think of alfalfa hay as being the biggest risk factor for blister beetle ingestion in a horse.
So what do people need to be aware of in terms of purchasing hay? I mean, what's kind of the guidance you have there?
So yeah, horse owners that want to feed alfalfa, and it is high protein, so there's a reason that we feed it. It's pretty high energy, so it's a good hay for horses. But if it is grown in areas where there are blister beetles, you have to be extremely cautious and work with somebody that is very knowledgeable about blister beetles. Or alternatively, there's a lot of bagged feed, so cubed or pelleted alfalfa. Or work with a hay dealer that actually imports their alfalfa from states where blister beetles aren't a problem.
Is there any risk for humans?
Not really. I think it's more of a nuisance, really. So certainly if you've got a big blister beetle problem, they happen to like get on you or they're under your shirt and you whack them, they can actually cause a blistering effect on the skin. So that toxin, the cantharidin that blister beetles have, there's a reason they're called blister beetles. It's really, really irritating to the skin and mucous membranes.
Are there years, I guess, when the blister beetles are worse than others?
Yeah, so particularly this year when I talk to my friends that are up north, because they've had a lot of hot and dry, their grasshopper population is really, really surged. And so these blister beetles, the young of them actually eat the eggs of grasshoppers. So essentially, you know, it's a multi-factor thing. So if we have a higher population of the grasshoppers as well, then that's going to drive up your blister beetle problems. And they may occur in places in the country where it's not normally a problem.
Obviously, this can be a hot topic. You have some fact sheets for those who want to learn more.
Yeah, absolutely. We have several of them that are available through Oklahoma State.
Okay, terrific. We'll check those out. Kris, thanks a lot. And for a link to the fact sheets we talked about, go to sunup.okstate.edu.